Alright, let's play some Mabinogi today. So I'm trying a Mabinogi stream that's a little bit later than my usual time. We're gonna do some stuff on Tuesday. I don't usually play Mabinogi on Tuesdays, but today we're going to. Oh, looks like we have a AP pot. Oh, that gives 300 AP, nice. And actually, I need to repair my gear really quick. Let's see, repair all this. And let's go take care of some homestead work. Trying to level this thing up. I forget if the next, like, homestead expansion is at level 13 or 14. I think it's at 13. Okay, so let's plant some more cabbages. We still have a lot of cabbage seeds. Okay, so there's 10 cabbage seeds, is that all we have? Oh wait, we still have 10 more, okay. I have a lot more than I thought. So these will be done in about 2.5 hours. Okay, so let's work on Grandmaster Puppetry. So I have 5 of the seals we need to pass. Let's go to Tara. So all three missions for Puppeteer. Alright, let's see what quests we have here. Single player Grandmaster mission. I'm not doing the Red Dragon one. 200 spiders. Let's do that one. No, we'll do that one second. We're all right here. We can do the. No, we'll do that one first. Then when we come back and turn it in, we'll do the Grandmaster mission, because we'll have to come back here and turn that one in. Okay, someone else is farming this graveyard, so I don't want to take away their spiders. Let's go to another channel. Let's go 3. Now someone else is farming this graveyard too. Let's check out channel 2. Find a nice empty graveyard. Okay, anyone here? Okay, I think this graveyard's okay. Thank you. go somewhere else to farm spiders. Let's see if this graveyard's empty. No, this graveyard is... Okay, this graveyard has two people in it. Just don't want to kill any spiders that other players need. So let's go channel 6. How about right here? Yeah, this one will do. Okay, 40 more to go. Thank you. Alright, we're done with all these spiders, so... we'll use our knuckles for the Grandmaster Shadow mission, and... I want to go back to my home channel, Channel 4, because that's the channel I love. Wait 8 more seconds? Alright. Okay, really quick, I'll be right back, and then we'll start that Grandmaster Shadow mission. Okay, so now for the Shadow Mission part of it. Thank you. Alright, all done with this. So let's turn in this quest. So now we have 7 out of 10 seals. And let's go Fort Conus for the beach event. Unless this is a full recovery potion one. And we can do some mini games over here. Let's talk to Doug. That have the bombs. Okay, good, we ain't hitting any of the bad ones. I already have all three of those carts on my main non-streaming character, so I don't need to work for that. Okay, dancing game. What's this one? Crap, messed that one up. Not fast enough for that one. Crap. Thank you. Okay, there we go. Right, and there's a puzzle game here. Well, those two pieces go together. Wasn't there also like a memory match game too? I think we have to talk to Ice for that one. Let's do this. There we go. Let's try that again. That one right there. Oh, I know where these are. Oops, failed. Okay, one more memory match. All right, well, now I'm not having a look at the memory match game, so let's play the Sacky Cake game once. Let's see, so I need... the strawberry one. Oh. Well, there's one. Alright, well, that's enough stuff here for now. Let's go to... Advancement Hall. No, not there. The North Theming Gate. And let's do some Dan tests. I guess before I do, I should check to see if there's any new Mabinogi announcements, because those usually come out on Tuesdays. So really quick, I'll be right back while I check out the main site and see if there's anything new and Mabby related to talk about. Let's, thanks for the follow. Doesn't look like there's any new Mabby posts yet, so there might not be a Tuesday announcement this week. But what kind of Dan tests should we take today? I need to get this up to 100. Yeah, I should finish up training up Fragment Shot, so let's go to Kernanug to get that trained up. Okay, so bow, arrows, we need to herd some zombies together. There's not even that many zombies out here, actually. Where are all of them? I think I need to wipe a few out so they'll start spawning in larger numbers. There's three That one's 4. I'm gonna need you as well. Come on over here. Good zombies. Come on, keep walking. Closer. All right, so now we have the 100 XP we need on that skill. So let's take off the quiver, we'll put it here, and then the bow, we'll put it here. And back to the advancement hall. We're gonna see if we can take that Dan 3 today. We'll need to pass the advancement test twice to do it. Okay, so combat. Crash shot? Yeah, crash shot Dan 3. That's what we want to aim for. Oh, right, we need 30k gold, okay. How much do I have? Not that. I forgot I put, like, all my gold in the bank. Oh crap, I actually should have taken out 60k because I'm going to need to take the test twice. Oh well, let's see how well we do on the first test. Which one's crash shot on? 4? Yeah, that's fine. A little distance between us and all these enemies. Thank you. Okay, so we got around 6,000 points. Oh, that's not good. So we need you better than that. Okay, let's try again. I'm not sure how high my score has to be to get like a passing grade on that, but that is a skill I would like to take Dan 3. This time's a massive failure just because of all that damage. Ooh. No, this time we're doing way better. Okay, are there any stamina potions around? Yeah, there's one. We'll lose 100 points off that, but we're already doing better than the last round, so it's not really a concern to me. Perfect. Okay, 12,900 points. There we go. So now we should have like half the XP we need. Let's go have a look. Yeah, we're 50% done. So we need one more Dan test that goes like that. We'll be right back. Okay, this is fine. I died in the last round, too. At least it regenerates my stamina. Stupid fish. Get out of here. Not quite as many points as last time, but like last time we got 12,900, this time we got 12,100. It's only like an 800 point difference. We should be fine. Perfect. So now we can take up Crash Shot to Dan 1. And that means all my archery skills have been taken to the Dan 3 rank. At least all the ones we can work on. Ranged Attack, Magnum Shot, and Crash Shot. All Dan 3. Okay, so this only increases the damage by 10%. That's not very much. Okay, so that's it for Dan tests. Nothing else to really do there. So So maybe I should pick up a few daily quests next. Let's go to Dumbarton, and let's see what the daily dungeon today is. Okay, so it's Berry Dungeon today. That's weird. There was Berry Dungeon yesterday, too. Well, let's go ahead and clear it. I think I'll use my shuriken for that. So this dungeon is two floors. Thank you. Okay, floor two. That's the right one. This is why having sport puppets a little nice. Okay, this is just an empty room with no purpose. So the next room probably has the boss key then. Time to deal with the boss. So mostly just gold and magic powder. So what are the daily shadow missions today, anyway? Ugh, I don't want to do those. Let's see what the VIP shadow missions are, because those will count too. Okay, so the VIP mission here is their method. That is shorter than the other alchemists. We'll do that. And then I'll use Chainblade skills for this one. Wait, and they actually pick up the mission. Oh, we did pick it up. That's weird. Usually if you're not in a party, it auto-creates you a shadow mission party. That time it didn't for some reason. We're still missing like one more group, aren't we? Yeah. Okay, I think I know where that group of zombies is hiding. So down this way. Here. Okay. And now to Town Square to finish the boss. Well, it's not really a boss, it's just a bunch of zombies in a room. Okay, let's go see what the VIP mission in Tailton is like. If I don't like any of the missions in Tailton, we can do the other alchemists. Use Ninja to get through that fairly quickly. Okay, yeah, let's do the other alchemists one, so... I think I'll do that one on hard mode, actually. I don't think I have an elite pass. No. Check off that event quest. So one more daily shadow mission. You get the coin. Let's use our knuckles, actually. Thank you. Wait, did I skip a room or something? Or do we go into the room in the center, like... No, not yet. What's going on here? We cleared this one. We cleared this one. Cleared this one. Yeah, we cleared this one, so that gate should be open. Why is it closed? Did the mission glitch? I'm trying to think if I forgot to do anything. But no, like, we've done everything right, so why is it... Why is that gate closed? It doesn't make any sense. Crap. I think the game bugged. That means we have to start over. Alright, I guess we'll exit and start the mission again. Unless it was something I was doing wrong, but I don't think so. Not sure what was going on there. The gate should have opened. Okay, so this time, when we actually pass this room, it should open that gate. Okay, that time it opened. I don't know why it didn't last time. Okay, so for the center room, let's summon all the enemies. Okay, actually, let's save that for the end. And there's also this room back here. Let's not forget about this. Okay, this room, one of these things again. Okay, so once we clear this room, that gate should open. Okay, please tell me we actually missed the room and that gate's actually gonna open like it's supposed to. Is this the mission glitched again? I'm not starting over again. What is with the mission today? The Xiao mission is all messed up. Oh wait, we did miss this room. Okay, good. I don't know why I missed this one, but I'm glad I missed the room, because if it glitched again, I would be really annoyed.
Thank you.
Okay, one more room. And let's skim with meteor from the other side here. We only have to enter the room. Done. Can use this to level up. Perfect. Get out of here. And really quick, I'll be right back, and then we'll do some dailies at Port Cobb. Okay, so let's go over to Cobb for a bit. Got a few dailies to do here. So I'm gonna need 5 large nails for the first one. Yeah, there's 2. And that glittering paper we picked up, if you use the, throw paper airplane action with glittering paper, it'll glitter. Look at it. There it goes. Oh, I was gonna see if I could throw it on the water, but I guess I can't. That one didn't go very far. Maybe when they eventually add swimming, it will be able to land on the water. Okay, so we get the daily from Madoc. And he's the one that wants 5 large nails, so we talk to him again when we have 5 large nails in our inventory. And done. And next, the request from Madeline. So he wants a striped marlin fish. Just talk to him when you have one in your inventory. I'm gonna have to get more of those fish soon. Okay, let's go ahead and complete that one. Let's get our daily from Uko the Trader. You can pick up your commerce daily from any trade helper. Which commerce daily do we have today? Make at least 3,000 seasonal ducats in profit through commerce. Okay. So if I recall correctly, the last time I played, we leveled up our E-Main rating to 8. Yeah. And the only rank 7 we have left is the one at Core Village, so I kinda wanna take that up to rank 8 before I heavily work on the other ones. So we're gonna commerce from Core, and we're gonna go to, like, other locations. So let's head to, Core Village. And the commerce post is right back over here. Okay, so one commerce round should be enough to pass this daily, but I'll probably do a few more after it from here. Let's see. Up those. Raid. This would sell for the most at Quilla. Is it faster to go to Quilla or to go to Vales? I don't actually know. Let's find out. We have to go all the way up here, and there, and here we have to go all the way through here. It's probably a little bit faster to go to Vales, but I'm not sure by how much. Probably about the same each way. Yeah, let's just take it to Vales. It's no problem. Quite a few people out here today. That's good, I like seeing Mabinogi active. And we need to gather an ice crystal. I'll save that other one for next time. And there's our bridge. These bridges melt in about 5 minutes. It's hard to see. I run into bandits out here. I don't know. I can't see a thing when it's like that. And done. And then let's go back to Core Village. This stuff is worth, 274 at Philly, yeah? Maybe I should take that there. No, if I'm going anywhere, I should go to Aquila, because it's worth like $4.91 there. It's worth a lot more than Aquila. It's worth the most in Belvest. Maybe what I'll do is I'll take this to Quilla, and then I'll check out Port Quilla, and if the ship is leaving fairly soon, maybe we'll go all the way to Cobb and then all the way to Belvest. That is a long journey, though. Okay, let's go ahead and take this Quilla. I'm not gonna do the same path to Vales every time when I'm leveling the core village thing, because that will just get boring. Okay, let's see what bridge we can take across here. Are both bridges up or just one? Yeah, both of them are up, that's good. So if the boat ride to Cobb isn't that bad, we'll go to Belvast. But if it is a long wait time, we'll just sell the crap here. Just gonna depend on how much time it's gonna take us to get to Quilla. I mean, from Quilla to Cobb. I really think they should just have a ship that runs from Idia to Belvast directly. Why do I have to go all the way back to U-Lab, past Belvast, only to get on another ship to go back the way I came and back to Belvast? It's ridiculous. They should either shorten, like, the travel times with the ships, or at the very least, add, like, a ship that goes directly from Idia to Belvast. And the silly thing is, like, this would be so easy to do, because all they would have to do is make the dock at Port Quilla look more similar to the new dock at Port Sion, so they could add two ships, and then one of them would go to Cobb, and then the other one would go to Belvast. And Belvast has more than enough room for a second ship. Okay, we're finally back at Quilla. So let's go check out that port really quick. Oh no, it's going to take forever to get all the way back to Port Cobb. I mean, look at this. This is a mess. Like, why is the dock designed this way? This is exactly the way the dock at Port Sion used to look like. And then they made it better. But, like, if we go to the main map, doesn't it make more sense to just make a ship that goes straight to Belvast instead of having to go all the way, like, straight to Belvast, like, right over here, instead of go all the way here, then travel literally more than halfway back, practically all the way back to Idia, and then go to Belvast again? This is ridiculous. They should just make this like the new, this dock like the new dock at Port Sion, where you can walk down it and it branches off in two different directions, and then they could have one ship going to Cobb and one ship going to Belvast. It'd be so much better than this silly system. Just doesn't make any sense to me to go back to Ulad when I'd be passing by the Belvast continent anyway, only to get on another ship to go back to Belvast. Like, how does that make any sense? Alright, we'll sell the scrap here. And I think that'll be the last round of commerce for now. So I think we'll wrap things up about here. This is going to be a pretty short stream. Let's go back to Philia. Too bad the guild update isn't on the roadmap for this year, as far as I know. It'd be nice to see that get updated too. Alright, well anyway, I think I'm gonna wrap up the live stream right here. So, I'm just doing with stuff with Xanafiedneko a little bit later. I'm thinking about changing my streaming hours, so I'd be working on Xanafiedneko from 4 p.m. PDT until like 10 p.m. PDT. I'm thinking about like starting that next week. So we'll see how that goes. For the rest of this week, I'll still have my normal Xanafiedneko hours. But anyway, I'll be playing Mabinogi again on Wednesday, so first thing tomorrow at my usual time.